Hi Vishesh, how are you?
I'm good. How are you?
Good, good, good. So how are you doing? What's keeping you busy nowadays? I know things are bad. You're from Uttarakhand, right?
Yeah, things are very bad, but still, I can do fitness and all everything, right now. Not the
Great.
ball practice, but still, we can work a lot of things in the
True,
home.
true.
So I'm doing
Yes.
that. Yeah.
Okay. Good. You're at least keeping yourself busy. Yeah.
Yeah.
Hopefully we come out of this soon. Yeah.
Yeah.
Sure. So Vishesh Brigubanshi, you are of course one of the best basketball players that India has ever produced. Right? You are currently the captain of the Indian basketball team, national basketball team. You have represented India in six FIBA Asia Championship, in the prestigious FIBA Asia Championship.
Yeah.
Then you also had a stellar season with the Bangalore Beast in the Indian Pro Basketball League. Right, and
Yeah.
also you were the first Indian, to be signed by the Australian National Basketball League, wherein you actually trained with the Adelaide 36ers, right? So to start, so that's quite a bit of achievement, overall. So to start off with, just wanted to understand, how did your basketball journey start? As a young kid, I'm sure you started playing basketball, and then when you actually started thinking and realizing that you're good enough to make a career out of basketball, so to say.
Okay, so I am basically from Varanasi, UP.
Right.
Okay, and my father was a teacher.
Okay.
Now he's retired, and there was a basketball court in front of my house. So, and the coach who was posted over there from the Sports Authority of India, he was my neighbor actually.
Okay.
So हमारा क्या था कि वो घर पे आते थे, पापा पापा से मिलते थे. तो he used to say like me
True.
and my brother, big brother.
Yeah.
Now his name is Vibhor Brigunchi. He's a assistant coach of under 16 men's team also.
Oh, wow. Okay.
So he used to call us. So my brother used to go actually, and I was like a small kid, so like play sometime football, cricket, whatever like friends are playing, I'm with them.
True, true,
But
yeah.
then फिर my brother took me to basketball ground. नहीं, you come with me. Once you'll start playing, you will have one discipline in your life and everything. Like slowly I went there and I started playing. And slowly, slowly, it was just like a thing that once you start going somewhere and once you are very deep in that, then
True,
you got
yes.
to realize that,
Yeah.
oh, I'm here now.
Yeah,
What to do?
you're made for this,
So
yeah.
with me it was same. Like I started playing. When I was too much serious about the game, then I realized, okay, I'm this much deep in basketball now, so no turn back. Let's go
True,
front.
true. Yeah, true, true, yeah.
Yeah.
And
So it
if
was just
we,
like,
Please go on, yeah.
so yeah, it was just that story. So my brother took me, then Amarjit Singh, who was basketball coach over there, he teased me the basics. And slowly, like so many other seniors, one another coach came from Sports Authority of India. Then over there, like Harjinder Singh, his name was Harjinder Singh. He teased me a lot. And Tridib Rai, my senior, he teased me, like the pro things in the basketball. So there was like that. They helped me a lot to become a good basketball player actually.
True, true, yeah. That's very important, So, if you really see your career graph, you've actually matured as a player, because you first made your debut at the 2009 FIBA Asia Championship, right? Then you played the FIBA Asian Championship in 2011, 2013, 2014, 2015. But in 2016, you actually had a, you showed that, yourself that you were, you were good in that. In fact, you averaged around 17 points per game, and then 4.4 rebounds, around 3.8 assists over a period of 8 games. So, what really went so right in that championship? Because you obviously that was, I think, your
Actually,
career best.
before 2016, that is Challengers Cup, what you are talking about. Before that, in 2015, there was an Asian Championship in China, and I was not the only one who did that. Actually, my squad, like from 2015, it was so fantastic. In 2015, first we came in the top 8, And after that, in the 2016, we came again, played the quarterfinal over there. And 2015 team went played very well. And I guess after 14 years, we reached the quarterfinal in Asian Championship. And we ranked 8. And after that, in 2016, Iran, we were the 7th placeholder. And the team played well. And with my experience and everything, maybe with the grace of God, I played well. And that was the stats, what you said.
True, yes. And the team that you're talking about, I'm not talking about Iran, before the Iran FIBA. Before that, in one of the Asia Championship, you actually beat China also, right? By about 7 points.
Yeah, in 2016, we beat China. And before that, in 2014, we defeated China.
Right, that's really some story, right? Because China is quite a good team, right, in basketball.
They are powerhouse of Asia. And actually, when we started playing, match started, you know, it was so hit that day. Match was going equal, you know, not nobody is having more than 4 points lead, up down. And somehow we reached in the last quarter. So I still remember it was just 1.5 minute or something, and match was like equal. So Scott Fleming was the coach, and he took the timeout and he called us and he was like, okay, so this is the move. That dunk video, actually, you may have seen that.
Yes.
Dunked, I had passed.
Yeah.
So that move he made, and he was like, okay, let's try this. And we actually did the same what he said. And that dunk happened. And after that too, we were so boosted up. Like, again, we defended them and came back. And I made a three-pointer and we got the five-point lead. And so it was so fantastic. After that, no, we got boost. And that win was awesome. And even though after that, we played against Iran also. We lost by 4. With Jordan, we lost by 3 or 5. So
yeah, all very close matches. We
played very, very,
very
good.
Correct.
Definitely.
True, and then in 2017, you actually went to train with the Adelaide 36ers, right? How was the experience?
Actually, I didn't went to Australia. I got drafted by them. Yeah. But before that, in Champions Cup, I got knee injury. So, I had my arthroscopy done, so I didn't went there.
Okay. Oh, you couldn't make it, right? Yeah. But you were drafted.
I had an injury, so I did operate my...
But how do you, recover?
After that, 7-8 months it took to me to come back. And then I came back. And first tournament I played in Hong Kong.
Yeah.
And then after that, this qualifiers, even though 3-on-3 Asia Cup, and one more tournament, that five games, all we played.
True. Now, talking about fitness, like you rightly pointed out, now in basketball, it's a very physical game, right? You need a lot of endurance, a lot of fitness required, a lot of strength and conditioning. So, what do you actually do on a daily basis for your strength and conditioning, your fitness regime? Because,
nowadays,
for 4 quarters, not nowadays.
It's very different. Nowadays, it's very different because of lockdown, and even though if lockdown is open also, like in my city it's open, but still it's too much scary, no, to go out and who knows who have corona or what.
True.
So it's like earlier though, it was like most of the time we spend in the Indian team camp, so it was like 7 to 8 months you are spending with the Indian team, and when you come back, you have your domestic tournaments with the team and everything. So, fitness, like once you are in Indian team, so they make us fit they make us actually properly, proper fit for the game. So, it was like after that, you just have to maintain that. So, after when they finish the camp, it is they just tell us that, okay, just maintain yourself. So, you come back, you don't have to, again, push yourself to come back at the same level.
True. Now, way back in 2008, you also won a gold. Helped India win a gold at the Asian Beach Games, right? In 3-on-3 basketball. Yeah, yeah. So how was that, environment with all the beaches around?
That was that was the first time when 3-on-3 has been introduced to Asia actually. And when we started preparing, so it was totally new for us. You know, like so many rules. Half court basketball, we know, like half court is totally, you know, very common in India. Most of the people play. It was quite comfortable for us also. But with the rules, once you go to the rules, deep in the rules. So that was, then it was like, very difficult. First you have to learn. So, but somehow we learned that rules and everything. And we started playing. So when we went there and we won our, league matches and everything. And then we were confident, okay. So this is our basketball, half court basketball. We can win this,
This.
So we reached the semi-final and we won. Then there was we played finals against Philippines, and Philippines was one of the good team over there. So it was like once we started playing final, it was like we were so tense. Even though I still remember one incident from that match. I used to play with the headband over there. What I did, I kept my headband over here in my hand and I started doing warm-up everything, and it was like for us, first time we are playing final in the international arena, and it was so, under se bahut tension tha, or we were so tense that what is going to happen and everything. So even though in full match, my headband was here only and I played. After the match, I realized I forgot to wear it under my head.
इतना मतलब tension और मतलब इतना जुनून जोश था कि आप भूल ही गए
मतलब. इतना tense बहुत मतलब and after that evening, we were sitting together and having tea. Then we were talking, अरे यार आज ऐसा हुआ ऐसा हुआ तो we were laughing की बता.
Oh my god.
But still, we won for the first time, and so it was like first time gold medal in India ke liye, and
obviously,
anthem is happening, flag is going.
Yeah. I mean that's obviously a total different feeling. Yeah. Now of course we in India, as you can see, we've got different leagues. Badminton league ho gaya, table tennis league bhi ho gaya, wrestling league bhi hai. IPL to hai, main cricket ke baare mein to baat karunga hi nahi. Usko to alag hi hai. Now basketball league chalu ho gaya hai. So do you think that basketball, pro basketball league is the way forward for promoting basketball in India and to make more interest going up for India in terms of basketball?
I guess basketball don't need any promotion actually. With my point of view, you can find basketball in every school, in every college.
Every court to head.
You cannot find other games, but you can find basketball in most of the college and school. So kids and young generation is totally, they are totally, ki basketball se bahut adopted, and everybody know ki this is basketball. True. And how they play, and with the NBA coming to NBA matches and all, people are very much interested ki dunks and this kind of reverse shots and all three pointers. So once you have a good basketball league, definitely it's going to be boom in India. So I don't think we need any promotion or anything.
You don't need
Start that.
And in 2017, when you represented Bangalore Beasts, you actually had a great tournament, right? On an average, you scored 31 points, and that too over some I think 11 games. Or Hyderabad ke saath to aap kuch alag hi kar diya, 57 points I think. मतलब क्या हो गया था आपको उसमें?
No, actually, that season for UBA, for me, it was awesome. I, played very extraordinary in that tournament. And I still remember that match, Hyderabad. And it was like so tense match because if Bangalore wins, we'll go up. If Hyderabad wins, they will go up to semi-final.
Okay, yeah.
So for us, it was do and die match, and for them also. So both was, playing so hard to each other that, we have to win. And with that feeling only, I guess, I played very well. That, you know, we have to win anyhow.
True.
That was
yes.
the feeling,
yeah,
I guess,
yeah, yeah,
for
yeah.
me
True.
To play that much better.
Obviously, yeah, yeah. Obviously, you'll be following NBA also, and then basically Sacramento Kings and Indiana Pacers, they came down to India also. So, whom would you follow most in NBA? Who would be your favorite players in NBA over the years?
For me, from the starting of my career, I only follow LeBron James, and I find him the best player in this world,
yeah.
Actually. Yeah, so I always followed him, and still I'm following because, you know, I always find something, you know, interesting, something different from others in him. Like, as a forward, as a point guard, wherever you put him, he'll give you his 100% and he'll play better. So, I always liked him.
True, yeah. So, what do you think is the future of Indian basketball? Of course, at the Asian level, we bring well in terms of FIBA, Asia Cup and all, we do well. So, what is the next level? I mean, what is the next level that we can reach, actually? I mean, our planning with Kaise Karna Chahiye Uske Liye?
No, see, nowadays, how Indian team prepares himself and how Indian team play. I guess we are doing very nice, and if we will not, you know, leave our path and will follow the same path, I guess very soon we can reach in the top four teams of Asia, because till top eight we was already in two years before, and some things happened, like my knee injury, Amritpal's knee injury, Amjot something, and so with some incident we came down, but still we didn't came that much down that we cannot go up. So we just have to, you know, follow our good path and with this coach Matic, and we can do a lot of, you know, good things. And with this now, too, even though we have an NBA academy in India and they are getting so much exposure, so I guess with that, so India should do some miracles in basketball very soon.
True. I mean, this is a kind of a naive question. I don't know. Jessica, in basketball, we all know people have 6 feet, 7 inch. Upper वैसे height अच्छा है, वैसे बोल रहा हूँ. Now, Indians, for example, we are not naturally have that height like a US, a typical American, you know, in term. So, is that some kind of a hindrance for us? I'm not talking to Indian national.
No, man. So many people ask this, that ki, you know, height matters for basketball or not. And yeah, really, man. Actually, dekho, height matters. If you have a good height, it is just like ki, if you have a small height, you have just one advantage that you can be fast. You know, and you can play as a point guard only. You can make a game maker. You can be, but if you have a height, you can, you know, play at 2-3 positions. So you have more options to play. This is the benefit, I guess.
Okay. So height is not a factor actually, right? Yeah.
No, actually.
Yeah, true. So talking about height, how do you basketball players, you know, manage to sit in a car, you know, typical Indian car, which is, say,
I-10? It's very difficult, man. It's very difficult. seat is in the lowest mode. Yeah. You know, backrest is behind. And seat is for totally backside. Like, if somebody is sitting behind me, he will be
he's gone.
Cannot, you know, put his leg more up.
Yeah.
Also, it's totally problem with us, but somehow, like, I have a big car, like Fortuner, so
we still
can be, you know, manage things. So.
True. So when do you think we can again, what is your next plan now? Of course, you can't plan now because we don't know when the competition will start and all that.
Nobody knows.
True. But how is it you're keeping yourself motivated, you know, mentally, you know, okay.
I'm just thinking, this is the time. This is a bad time actually, and it will go someday. Definitely it will go. It can't stay, you know, forever. So, just I'm hoping that everything will be fine soon, and you know, but I just have one thing in my mind that once this situation will over, I should not be unfit. I should be fit enough to play basketball again.
That's very true. Yeah, yeah.
So I'm just thinking that, and I'm doing whatever I'm trying to do for my fitness.
True. So obviously you are engaging yourself in home fitness, how much you can, right? Yeah. True.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Yeah, Vishesh, it is really great chatting with you. I mean, of course, you have done wonders for the country, and we really hope to see you in the basketball court very soon again, after all this situation gets over. And yes, like always, we will keep on following you and the Indian team, of course, you know, and bring more glory to Indian to India. Yeah, yeah. Thank you so much, Vishesh, for taking all your time, and all the best. And of course, take care, stay safe here.
Thank you. Thank you. Bye-bye.
Bye, Vishesh.